Now we are starting lesson number 8 of chemistry and its chapter chemical equilibrium. The topic is finding the values of equilibrium constant and it's on page number 14 and 15. How to find value of Kc? As we have learned it in the previous lecture that the value of Kc can be found experimentally, but how? The value of equilibrium constant can be calculated if we know the concentrations of the reactants and the products in the equilibrium mixture. So you can calculate the value of Kc if the concentration of reactants and products will be given. The values used in the equilibrium constant expression are concentrations, not numbers of moles. Moreover, there are the concentrations of the reactants and the products at equilibrium. Means the concentration means of reactants and products will be given at equilibrium state, and you can then put the values in the chemical equilibrium expression and you can find out its equilibrium constant, value of equilibrium constant or value of Kc. This is example through which you can understand how to calculate value of Kc. In the equilibrium mixture, the concentration of hydrogen and iodine is 0.04 moles per decimeter cube. Means concentration of hydrogen is 0.04 moles per decimeter cube and also of iodine 0.04 moles per decimeter cube each, while that of hydrogen iodide is 0.08 moles per decimeter cube. Find Kc of the following reaction. First of all, you have to write the balanced chemical equation. H2 plus I2, that will give HI, but you have to balance it. So 2 hydrogen over here, 2 iodine over here. So for that purpose, here must be a 2 to balance the chemical equation on both sides. Now, the value for H2 and I2 is given and also of HI. What you have to calculate and what is unknown here, that is Kc. The balanced chemical equation is this one. The chemical equilibrium expression, you have to make it first. So that Kc is equal to product by reactants. Product of products by product of reactants. And the exponent will be raised to power. So HI raised to power 2, and for H2 and I2 that is 1. Substitute the given values for the concentrations into the equilibrium expression. So by putting the value of HI and H2 I2, you have to take power of it and multiply them both and then divide. So you will get the answer, and that is 4. So you get the value of Kc. How? If you know the concentrations of the reactants and the products both. Is it clear? The next example is example number 9.4, in which the equation is CO plus H2O and it will give carbon dioxide plus hydrogen. So I'm directly showing you that you have to first put the data. You have to first make the data like the given data, that is for CO, H2O, CO2 and H2. That will be given in the question. Kc is unknown, the equilibrium constant expression. So keeping this equation in mind, you have to first make the equilibrium expression. So that is CO2 and H2 are products. So that will be in numerator and the reactants will be in the denominator. Now the values are given, just put that values in the square brackets. So by putting the values in the square brackets, you have to calculate it then, and the answer is 6.25. and here you can see no unit over here. Why? Because the mole per decimeter cube are 2 above and 2 below, so all will cancel out and there will be no unit for this case. Same for the previous one. Here the power was 2, so 2 mole per decimeter cube over here and 2 over here, so both get cancelled out, no units in both case. Now what's your homework? The homework is you have to practice problem 9.4 given on page number 15. It is same as the given examples in this lecture. You have to Take help of these examples and then calculate the value of Kc. I hope you will do that, inshallah. Thank you, class.